exercise 7 regarding functional asymmetry for Dolby-Baston. It's really about changing the targets, the altitude of the targets. When you look at the Solo-Baston system, you're taught that the primary target are the hands. Smash the hands, he drops a weapon. You're also learning where the secondary target is, the eyes. So quick jabs or thrust towards the eyes will, again, make him flinch, and that's your secondary target because it's fairly close. And the tertiary target, as you discover later on, especially with the circular strikes, are the knees. If you blast out his knees, you reduce his footwork capabilities, and of course, it looks like yours are better. So with this, we're going to apply it to Dolby-Baston, and in uprights, if you use uprights as the example, typically you're hitting the opponent's hands with uprights. In this variation of this exercise, you'll be changing where those targets are. So it could be hitting the eyes for 3 shots, hitting the hands for 3 shots, and hitting the knees for 3 shots. Or you can start alternating what those targets are, again, using uprights, where it might be eye, hand, knee, eye, hand, knee. It could be eye, hand, knee, knee, hand, eye. And again, the wider swath you make in terms of the range of targets means a larger area for him to defend and be aware of. This applies to actually different attacks as well, where you start randomizing what those targets are. So it won't matter if I'm delivering thrust at the eyes and then switch to a hand shot, or take the knee, take the eyes before I get a hand shot. But whatever you do, you're changing the altitude of the strikes to make him, to put him on the defensive more. In addition to aiming the strikes, you can also change your altitude. So as I'm aiming for the eyes and the hands, I might go low for the knees, take out the hand, aim for the eyes, and then again, blast out the knee. But that's the idea behind exercise 7, where you're trying to be asymmetrical in your attacks, and therefore more unpredictable.